Welcome to God's workshop. Our hearts that we surrender to Him becomes the place where He works His amazing stuff for us. I'm here with a motorcycle, a very definite and distinctive motorcycle called a BMW Boxer. This motorcycle has a very specific sound to it. Its designers designed it so that it would be audible above any other motorcycle. And that makes me think of you and I. You see, our Creator Jesus Christ said, out of the abundance of our hearts, our mouths will speak. So our characters and our heart condition is defined by the words that come out of our mouths. And when we understand it's not just a voice pattern, but it's either words that are going to bring healing or words that are going to bring hurt. And most hurting people hurt other people. Either they bully them physically or they bully them with their words and they abuse them with their words. What a privilege to have a voice and a sound that we can use positively. What are you known for? What's your distinctive sound? Is your distinctive sound one of blessing and encouragement? Or is it a distinctive sound of negativity and breaking people down? We know that our words have creative power. The scripture says that life and death are in the power of our words. You see, what we often do is we think so negatively about people and our worldview is so negative that we in our minds already call them names and categorize them. And then they live up to our negative expectations because my mind is looking for the negativity and the wrong in people's lives. Isn't it good to know that God sees us so differently? You see, the scripture says in the book of Proverbs, chapter 15 and verse 4, gentle words bring life and health. A deceitful tongue crushes the spirit. What a privilege to be able to use our tongues to bring health and to bring help to people rather than the opposite. Remember too, when you want to give people a piece of your mind, please don't do that because you don't have enough to give away. Keep what you have and use it positively for the building of people rather than the destruction of people. Remember this, the scripture says again in Proverbs chapter 18 and verse 4, a person's words can be life-giving water. Wow, words of true wisdom are as refreshing as a bubbling brook. Choose to speak life and bless people rather than blast them. God bless you.